Why did Aquaman Splashdown drown? What was it past life? Why did it leave? Why did it leave so soon? Find out today on JB Archives. Aquaman Splashdown originally opened in 1987 at Splash Waterfalls. It was a Hopkins shoot-the-chute ride. Riders would go up a lift hill, curve around, drop, and then get soaked with lots of gallons of water. The ride had many reincarnations. It wasn't always named Aquaman Splashdown. The ride was white and just really plain. As of now, where it's green and blue, which is Aquaman's signature color. If you remember, this ride was okay. When I rode it, this ride was kind of scary to me because I was little. The handlebar didn't lock all the way. It had no seatbelts, and the water was just a little bit gross. You see other water rides, and their water's at least a little bit blue or a little bit clear, but this is like nasty water. It smelled when you got out of the water, it smelled like you went into the ocean. But beside my personal experience, this ride was the number one summer hit for Six Flags Over Texas. Now, even though this ride is not unique, the uniqueness doesn't come from the ride, it comes from its many reincarnations. Originally, in 1987, it was opened at Splashwater Falls, a not unique name, pretty basic. But here comes the weird ones. In 1995, because of the Right Stuff Motion Simulator Theater, it was named Splashdown Reentry Test. That's weird. Then in 2000, just Splashwater, which was extremely basic. I think the weird one was a simulation. But finally, in 2007, it was finally named Aquaman Splashdown, which is the only ride themed to Aquaman in the whole world. Aquaman wasn't as famous, so when it got named this, people were actually kind of excited about it since Aquaman was not very, you know, popular. It was more Batman, Superman, Wonder Woman, stuff like that. But here's the problem about the ride. It didn't have a long wait time. Even if it was the hottest day of the year, it wasn't, unless it was really hot, like 103, like here it is in Texas, the lines would be like 1 hour long. But other than that, it wouldn't be that long. It'd be like 15 minutes or less, just a walk-on ride. And as soon as you exit the ride, you go on this bridge, and the boat would splash you, and if you didn't cross the bridge faster, you would be wet, like soaked, and it would take 3 hours to dry. Honestly. But suddenly, this last year, the ride didn't open. Six Flags announced last year that Yosemite Sam, River Adventure, and Aquaman got flooded. Basically, Aquaman drowned. And because of this ride was beyond repair, so they had to take it out. And now, Aquaman's gone. Yosemite Sam, though, I don't know what's going on with that. But Aquaman is no longer gonna stay. It left the park in August. But then, when the 2020 announcements came along, they finally announced what's gonna replace Aquaman Splashdown. There were rumors of RMC Raptors, another coaster, Infinite Coaster, but then, out of the blue, which people were saying, Dubai wanted to give up their Mac Power Splash because Six Flags Dubai won't be a thing. So Six Flags bought it, and they're like, oh, you know what, let's replace Aquaman. So yeah, now in 2020, say hello to Aquaman Power Wave. It'll still be themed to Aquaman Power Wave, but the ride will be unique, higher, and better. Hopefully it has a turntable. It was just the animation, though. That was a mistake. But Aquaman Splashdown will no longer be in the park, and most of these shoot-the-chute rides are leaving. Just like Power Surge in Texas got replaced for Wonder Woman, and another leaves. But Aquaman Splashdown will always be remembered, especially if you rode it. And it'll be saved in the JB Archives. And hopefully this ride will be a lot better than that one. But the original Aquaman is drowned and dead. And the new one's better. So thanks for watching JB Archives. And shout out to Coaster Fusion. He's a really cool roller coaster YouTuber like me. And check out his channel. And thanks Coaster Fusion for watching my videos.